behind your head looks like your father's Kansas City jersey. How does it feel for you to be chasing that legacy?
You know, I just feel it's sort of an honor, you know, just looking at him play when I was younger and sort of following his footsteps. You know, I just think it's the ultimate achievement to get to where I'm at today. And, you know, I know he's proud of me. And, you know, I'm just going to keep on carrying that legacy on.
How long have you been playing corner?
I've been playing corner probably since I was in middle school, since like eighth grade. But I really started like playing it fully in high school, freshman year.
So did your pops let you play other positions and then tell you what you were going to do? Or did you make that decision?
No, I made that decision. Pops, you know, he was just whatever was best for me. You know, but I just felt like, you know, I was good at other positions on offense, like receiver, running back, things like that. But I just felt more natural at corner. And, of course, my dad, you know, having the pedigree, playing in the league for several years, playing that position, I just think that, you know, my intelligence from that position, I think it helped me, you know, going into the next transition to high school.
Did you ever doubt your ability?
No, I never did. I just felt like, because I know I already had the athleticism. I know I had the speed, the strength, the physicality. It's just, you know, just getting developed. And, you know, just getting the technique down and just being the best version, the best player of myself.
So going to American Heritage and Plantation, where they're not even trying to hide it, coming up in Broward County, like, what is it like for you to know you come from this South Florida, really just recruiting hotbed, but where some of the best high school football is played? Excuse me.
It's like a machine. It's like a factory in South Florida. We got talent year in and year out. Just knowing that coming from one of the top states of football in the country, you know, it just goes to show you the amount of talent that each South Florida player brings to a college team.
One of the things I think is really just very cool and underrated about your game is you made 38 consecutive starts at corner, which is to say that you showed up as a freshman and were ready to play. How do you feel that has prepared you for the NFL?
I think it prepares me a lot, especially playing early at Alabama in the SEC. You know, I'm going against top NFL talent each and every week and each and every day, of course, in practice with the type of receivers we had. But, you know, I think coming into Alabama, I was prepared for it. You know, I was working hard for it. And I think when my name was called upon that time, I think I was ready to play and compete. And now here I am, you know, just going to one of the biggest stages of my life. And, you know, I'm just ready for draft day to have my name called.
So I spoke with Jalen Waddle a little bit earlier in this process, this NFL draft process. And I asked him who was a better corner. Is it you or your pops? And he said it was you. How does that make you feel?
Man, that's like a big honor. You know, my dad was a three-time Pro Bowler, shoot all pro, all that. But I think he said that because, you know, we go against each other every day, and we get each other better. He bring the best of me, and I bring the best of him out. So I just think that it goes hand in hand into what he's trying to say because, you know, each day in practice, he know how I play, and he's know what I'm capable of. So I just think that's, in his perspective, that's how he feel.
So I was going through the wide receiver depth chart, like a lot of folks that love this sport do, and it occurs to me that you match up with Henry Ruggs, Jerry Jeudy, Jalen Waddle, Devontae Smith, John Metchie. The list goes on, but I'm going to ask you to pick one. Which one of those dudes was the coldest wide receiver that you played against?
Man, it's crazy because, like, when you say that, people don't understand, like, how deep that roster really was. Cause you can't relax in practice at all. You can't take a rep off. You got to go hard each and every play. Cause each of them are capable of, you know, making, embarrassing you. So, but I don't know. I think all around best receiver, cause I went against Smitty like day in and day out. So I think, you know, me and him had our fair share. I just think he's the best all around. But, you know, they all got their own qualities, their own traits, you know.
What was it about Smitty that was most difficult to defend against?
It's just that he's so fluid and he's so smooth in his route running, and he's so smart on the field. And I think that that's what separates him a lot, because he understands defenses. You know, he's his senior year, I think he, of course, took his game to another level, like he hasn't already had been. But I think this year it really showed, like, his experience in college. And, you know, he wasn't just out there running routes. He was dissecting the defense and understanding what they was trying to do to stop him. So I just think that helped him carry his game to the next level this year.
Do you have a favorite Nick Saban story that you like to tell that you could tell us?
Nick Saban? Okay. Okay, one story is that we was on the field. It was hot, fall camp. You know, and everybody's already like in a tight shell. You know, it's hot. Everybody's competing. We grinded. The next thing you know, I went out there, and it was a play that they called. And I wasn't very familiar with it, but then I went out there, and I did the whole play wrong. Like, I messed up the assignment, everything. The next thing you know, I even want to look back. I look back. And then I see him throw his hat. You know, he got the big bucket hat, the little leather hat. He threw it on the ground. And next thing you know, him is cussing me out, yelling at me, fussing at me. And next thing you know, I realized that, okay, I'm in Alabama now. I realized that, yeah, I'm getting coached by Nick Saban. But, you know, after that, you know, I understood that he expected greatness out of me. And, you know, when I look back at it, I think it helped prepare me for the best.
Yo, man. Ain't everybody built to receive that? Like, what is it like to be coached that hard all the time?
It's something that you're going to have to grow into, because sometimes you ain't going to like it. Sometimes you're going to feel some type of way about it. But at the same time, when he critique you, you got to understand that he wants the best for you. And, you know, just going on throughout my years at Alabama, I understood the reason and into why he coached us so hard. You know, he expect greatness out of each and every one of his players. And, you know, when we go on the field, it just shows, like, how hard we work. You know, just understanding what he says and how he wants to apply it on the field. I just think that, you know, at the end of the day, when you look back at it, you look at it as like a sort of a step ahead going into the next level, and that you always need to work hard and never get complacent.
Do you have a welcome to Alabama moment, like when you knew that, hey, I'm not in plantation anymore, I'm not playing high school football anymore, this is real?
A welcome to Alabama moment? Okay, I remember it was actually my first workout. I never told nobody this before, but it was my first workout freshman year. And, you know, how high school be, you go to sleep, you wake up at a certain amount of time, but in college, you better wake up 15 minutes, 20 minutes before your workout, or else you're going to be in some trouble. So I woke up, not knowing what the time was. Workouts were at 6:30 in the morning, so I woke up at like 6:32. I woke up to like 20 missed calls, 50 messages saying, where you at, where you at? Then I got there, and I realized, like, man, I'm in trouble. So Coach Cochran, he was our strength coach at the time, he realized that I was late. Everybody knew I was late on the field. And he made an example out of me. He made me bear crawl the field, roll, do all that. Then he made me go back into the workout that everybody else was doing and made me finish the whole thing. So after that day, I never was late. I made sure I was on time. I woke up probably like 15 minutes prior to the workout or meeting just to make sure that never happened again.
Yo, man, I can only imagine. Like, I've seen Coach Cochran yell. I've seen him be on people. It ain't nowhere I want to be. So I can only imagine what was out, like, out there doing all of that work and then having to do more work. But you didn't quit. But did you call your dad and you'd be like, yo, man, I don't know if this is the right place for me?
Nah, I ain't calling my dad. But he knew what happened. And he told me, man, you got to get together. You got to get yourself together. Because he'd been in my shoes before, but college is a whole different ballgame from high school. Whether it's in the classroom, on the field, you just busy all day and every day. you got to prepare for it, just make sure you're on top of things and being well organized.